Hey, welcome back, everybody. Hey, check it out. As you can see, I'm back doing my copycat recipes, right? Today, I'm doing Red Lobster's Shrimp Scampi. And guess what, folks? I got a twist for it. Let's get it. All right, now listen, I'm talking about a trick, right? So first thing I want to do is I want to introduce this potato to you. You guys are going to want to, you know, make these. So check it out. I preheat my oven to 350 degrees. Now I'm going to show you what I'm going to do, right? So let me go ahead, get myself a fork. And what we want to do is we want to just start putting some holes in it. Why? Because when we have it in there and it starts to steam, you want some of that steam to come out, right? So we put them that way. And then listen, I just look at the way it naturally, you know, fits. Right now, I'm gonna go ahead and just make a line from here and just go across, you know, with my fork. You guys are gonna understand this in just a minute, but I'll give you a little preview of it. When you put this little line right here, it makes it easy. So when I go ahead and push it this way, it opens up. And I show the flesh of the, you know, the potato, right? Now, I'm gonna go ahead and hit it with my infused olive oil. Listen, it's time to level up, folks. Right, this helps crisp up the skin. Right, and put this back down like that. That's where I put the line. I put all of the holes in there, right? Now check this out. Now I want you guys to pay attention. Check these out right here. All these are sea salts. Listen, we got a black truffle sea salt. We got that bacon flavored sea salt. Then we got that black garlic sea salt. Now I just want to show you guys, look, I'm gonna be using the bacon flavored on here. I know that this is a vegan product. You guys got to smell it. It smells smoky, got that bacon flavor. Tell you it's bacon right off the back, but it's not, right? This is what we're gonna be using to put on the outside. I take it, I can see my holes in there from when I was, you know, working on it. You know what I mean? If it don't stick like you want it to, you can just always add yourself a little bit more. It depends on how long. But because I was getting everything ready, you know what I mean? We was coming up with like a little bit of a, you know, a delay. So it kind of like soaks into the potato, right? So now we just put this on here like this. And this is what we want. I know you guys, some of you guys don't eat the skin. Listen, I do though, folks. Now, because it's only me, that's why I only have the baked potato for myself. Usually I do four at a time. You can always find somebody that want to have shrimp scampi on their baked potato. But I'm going to show you something about that butter. Instead of using regular butter, we're going to use some of that scampi butter. Ah, I'm going to save it. Just hold up. Now we're going to put this in the oven. I'm going to set a timer. We're already at 350 degrees. I'm going to set a timer for just 1 hour. All right, so now that we put the baked potato on the in the oven, I want you guys to pay attention to these ingredients out here. Look, there is not a whole lot. Now, don't forget, the full printable recipe will be on my website, Smokin and Grillin with AB.com, and that's WITAB.com, right? So listen, one of the things about the website is, even though you're going there, you might just want to go to the website just to get yourself dinner ideas. So many recipes on there. Listen, I'm finna load it up. We've been working hard trying to get it all together, right? So as you see, not a lot of ingredients. I'm gonna be using my pan. This is my shrimp. This is to get all of the residual, you know, water off of them. And I think we're gonna start cooking about 45 minutes into the hour cook with the baked potato. That way, when we finish this, because it's a very fast recipe, baked potato will be finished, and I can show you the level up on that, folks. Okay, so look, we got everything covered. Baked potato is ready. I set my oven on 200 degrees just to keep it, you know, warm. First thing we're getting ready to do now is put a little heat under here, and then we're gonna add some olive oil to it, right? So I usually get it out of here. For some reason, when I was loading up everything, I just went ahead and just like measured it out. Don't ask me why, folks, I did that. I don't know, and I don't have enough. Right, so we just add some more there. Now that's that infused olive oil. The same thing I showed you with the sea salts, that's Branch and Vines. You know what I mean? I'll put all of the, you know, products and the information in there. Listen, this is why we start with, if we start with like good quality products, this is why we end up with like great results. You know what I mean? So, real simple, infused olive oil, and that's right here infused with. This one right here is garlic. Okay, so if you look right here, look at how easy this is to, you know, stir it around. That's another way you know it's right. And then if I look off and I can see some of the ripples on there, that's telling me we're good, right? So now I've already took out that napkin you saw to like pick up any extra moisture. What you want to do is when you put this in here, you want to make sure all your shrimp is flat. Now I'm using a medium high heat, you know, right before I put them in here, right? I start off on medium just to get it nice and warm, then I go to medium high. Now what you want to do is you want to start flipping them. You see them starting to turn pink? Listen, this process right here, hot pan, olive oil, all of that, I can tell you that under a medium heat, it only gonna take about 2 to 3 minutes. So by the time I finish getting all of these turned over, letting them get some heat, it'll be time for me to take these out. Now really after about like 5 minutes, right, I move them around, make sure nothing is sticking. Whoa, don't try to escape. What I'm gonna do now is, I'm gonna tone my fire back to like medium, right? Now I'm gonna take these, and I'm gonna take these out. Now I want you guys to look. Let me just go ahead and get this. I'm gonna get it all. We wanna get all of the flavors. Now, depends on what type of pan you're using, or skillet, look at that right there. That's defined. That's a lot of flavor. Now, I like to make a lot of it. You know what I mean? So what I'm gonna do is, we still got that medium flame going underneath the bottom. I'm gonna go ahead and just add this in also. I did mine in batches. Actually, I did a little bit more than a pound, you know? So we just put these on here just like this. Once I get them flat, I'm gonna raise this back up to medium high. All right, so now if you guys look right there, look, that's all of the shrimp done. Two batches, look at there, y'all. If that don't do it, I don't know what will. Now, I want you guys to notice this. Look, these little dishes right here, check it out. I think Red Lobster use a blue one like this, but we're gonna get this just the way they make theirs. Okay, so once you got your shrimp out, I turned my fire out during that last little batch, right? At the end, I turned it off to allow it to cool. Then I turn my fire back on after it's cooled a little bit, and then I go to a medium flame. Now what you wanna do is you wanna add your butter, right? Now this is 6 tablespoons, right? This is gonna be the key, folks. That's why it's so much butter. Now, I'm using hex clad pots and pans. You know, whenever you guys see me cooking, unless I'm using my cast iron, and really nothing sticks to the bottom, you know? So you see how this just melts, not burning, you know what I mean? And it's picking up everything on the bottom also. But butter will be your tool of choice. And guess what, folks? We finally cooking with unsalted butter. Right? Now, you know, we got these garter cloves over here. I'm gonna be using my press. Getting ready to put a big smile on my face. You know, let's put this big one in there first. And what I'm gonna do is, we got it on medium, so we don't have to really burn it. We don't have to worry about burning it, correct? So now we're just gonna go ahead and just mince this down. Just like this. Now, let me continue to do the rest of the butter. You know what I mean? Because by the time I finish that, this is gonna be nice and right. So after about 30 seconds maybe, or 1 minute, if you have medium, you're good. What we wanna do is, we wanna add a little white cooking wine, right? Just add a little bit to it. This will help deglaze for those of you guys that don't have a nonstick. And even these pots right here, you might feel something as you're moving it around, but this will help it deglaze, right? Then you just wanna go ahead and cut your lemon, right? Cut that in half and start adding that to it too. I use my fingers and use them as a strainer and just rotate this, you know, with my hand as I'm squeezing. Make sure I don't get no seeds in there and to make sure that I get all of the lemon juice. You only need about half of it. Now under a medium heat still, right? You want to cook this down and reduce this down some. It'll start to thicken up once it cooks out our white wine and some of the lemon. You know what I mean? You can see it's starting to do it right now anyway. So look at that. And then I'm gonna move this back like this. Look at how clean that is. You ain't always gotta have that onion, folks. You know what I mean? That white rind does it. A little heat, cook all that up. That combination between that and a lemon, that's how you come up with that. All right, as we're waiting for this to continue to cook down, right? You guys can see it. Starts to thicken up, like I told you guys, right? So before I add my Italian seasoning to it, I'm gonna go ahead and take my parsley, and I'm gonna go ahead and get this ready. Okay, so once we cook the white wine out, now we go ahead and add our Italian seasoning. This is about the consistency that you want right here. We're not looking for a gravy, folks. So now we're gonna go ahead and reintroduce our shrimp, well, we might as well say introduce, and all of its juices. you know what I mean, to it, right? This warms it back up and drops its flavor inside of it too. And that's what makes it taste the way it does, folks. So, look at this right here. You want to get them nice and coated. Mm. Then you add that parsley for a little bit of the flavor, but you know what? It marries good with everything that's in here already. But look at it though. It gives it that little pop. You know, that little green. Yes, sir. Only thing left to do is hit it with just a little bit of this parm on there. Look at that, folks. Remember, we under like that medium heat. It's like a medium low, right? I just put this in here right now to give it that velvety, you know, texture with it. Don't need a whole lot, folks. All right, fam, so look, these make great appetizers, you know? So I'm gonna go ahead and just put these in here like that, and now it'll start to resemble, you know, Red Lobster's Shrimp Scampi. Right? Then I'm gonna take some of this, just coat it, clean that up on the sides, and there you go. Okay, so look, with the baked potato ready, I don't know if you guys can see the perforation that I put on the top right there. I'm gonna show you how it makes it so much easier, right? So look, I'm gonna go ahead and get my towel, because it's still a little hot. I had turned off everything and started letting it cool. Hopefully we don't have no issues right here, but if I take it like this and just push it, look at this right here. See how it just opens up, right? Now, if you go ahead and, it's really like the shape of what we had, right? But look how soft this is. Right? Just take it, you know, push it down. I got it. You can see the steam coming up out of it. Right? Now, you want to talk about like it being the secret? Now, you know we got all that scampi juice, right? Why wouldn't we use that with all the garlic and all of that? All right, so what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna go ahead and get a little bit of this. This out the way. We take a little bit of this and we come over here and we just add that to it. And that right there gives it that scampi flavor, folks. That's what I do. When I'm at Red Lobster, look, I eat my scampi and I take all of the butter, all of the goodness there, and I just add it to my baked potato and then I knock that off. Right, so I don't know about y'all, but I like to have bacon on mine a little bit, you know. Look at this right here. Talk to me, let me know down in the comment section below how you get out to do yours. Right, I'm gonna put just a little bit of cheese on here, you know what I mean, just a little bit. Then if you really feel froggish, right, even before I hit it with a little bit of that you know, sour cream, I go ahead and just add these, just like you see, folks. Yes, sir. And we just put just a little bit more cheese on the top. Now, when it comes to the sour cream, you could mix that in there and then put your scampi, you know, sauce on top. But I just like to put it in, you know, just like you see. You know what I mean? Because I don't want to put it on top, because usually I eat mine off the, you know, just off of the top, to be honest with you. Right? And then that last little bit of flavor that I can get up out of this pan. And there you have it. Can't never have too much bacon. Now I want you guys to tell me, what would you do to make this just a little bit over the top, more than it already is? All right, so look, I really don't know where to begin. I done ate some out of there. I went to pass it around. Everybody now got to like pop hands. Look, you can see there's no more in there. I just got a few on the baked potato. Then I got some right here in these little two little trays, right? Hey, super simple to make and like huge on the flavor. Like they, shrimp scampi is the way to go, folks. Now you guys let me know what you think. Now, you know what? Let's do it like this. I'm gonna go ahead and get myself a toothpick. You know what I mean? Quit doing it like I've been doing it. Just reaching in there and grabbing one. But I was doing it out of the pan, but as you can see, it's no more, right? So now I can go like this, sop up some of that butter. Cheers, y'all. Yes, sir. You gotta love my job. You know what I'm saying? I get to taste, eat, sample, cook with, all of the above. Now, let me know what you guys would do. Also, listen, when you talk about scampi, sometimes we can just go ahead and get ourselves some like spaghetti noodles. I made a video before, which I'll link right here. You know, you guys can click on that and just check it out. I made it with pasta noodles too. Hey, listen, the sky's the limit. You know what? But I got to put a ceiling on it for me because I can only do so much with it. Would love to hear about what you guys would do. Now, if you're new to my channel, let me take this time to say thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and tell everybody out there. There's a channel out here that's simplifying these recipes and taking a mystery out of cooking. And you know how I get down, folks. Last one out of the shrimp plate. And now it's time to eat the baked potato. I'm out. Peace.